Shaitan Rajim. Bismillah Rahman Rahim. Today we are starting at Al Mahdi Sunday School, class number 39. Today's topic is Lifestyle of Imam Ali. Peace be upon him. As tonight is night of Wilada, that is why, and in Jashan we will discuss about Imam Jawad alayhi salam. This class will not be more than 40 minutes. Within 40 minutes, inshallah, we are going to discuss about footsteps of Imam Ali. Check the brightness. First and foremost, let me tell all of you, Imam Ali alayhi salam was born in Al-Kaaba. Nobody else was born in Al-Kaaba. That is why he is titled as Mauludo Kaaba. In Urdu we say Maulude Kaaba. Maulud means who was born in Al-Kaaba. Thirteenth year of Amul Fil, after the Kaaba was attacked by Abraha, after 13 years of Amul Fil, he was born in Al-Kaaba. His father, Hazrat Abu Talib alayhi salam, his name was Abdu Manaf, and title was Imran. Kunyat was Abu Talib. Talib was oldest son of Hazrat Imran, oldest brother of Imam Ali. Do you know four names of sons of Abu Talib? Number one, Talib. Number two, Aqil, Jafar. Number three, Aqil. Number four, Imam Ali, alayhi salam. So these are four sons of Abu Talib, and he got one daughter. Do you know name of daughter of Ummehani? Very good. Ummehani. Ummehani, it is kunyat. She was famous as Ummehani. So these five children of Abu Talib and Fatima bint Asad. Out of five, one was born in Al-Kaaba. And that was Imam Ali alayhi salam. Before we discuss the lifestyle, let me tell all of you, this is the first child whose mother and father were Hashmi. Before that, it never happened. Al-Hashmiya. It means these four brothers, five children, their parents were both Hashmi. It never happened before. It happened later on, but before that, paternal and maternal side, both were never Hashmi. Either one Hashmi, one non-Hashmi. But this was the one of the upgrades of this family. Yeah. Parents, his father was Hashmi, Abdullah, alayhi salam. But Amina bint Wahab was from Medina. She was not Hashmi. Yes. She was? Yes. Of course, yeah, they were Ansar. Yes. Hashmi means the sons of, sons and daughters of Hashim. Abdul Muttalib's generation. Progeny of Hashim. Okay, third point before we enter into lifestyle is Abu Talib alayhi salam was custodian of Al-Kaaba. He got key of Kaaba. He used to open Al-Kaaba. He used to close the haram. He used to clean. That is why maybe Allah arranged birth of Imam Ali from new door. If mother of Imam Ali was entering into the routine door, the people used to criticize that custodian would have give her, his wife, the key of Al-Kaaba. What is upgrade? That is why Allah has opened a new door for Imam Ali and closed that door. And when Prophet came to pick up Imam Ali and take his aunt with him outside of the Kaaba, Allah had opened again from the same place twice, once for Imam Ali, once for Prophet Muhammad. And he came out from this non-routine way. He was born on 13th and he was taken out of Al-Kaaba on 16th. 3 days complete, Bibi Fatima bint Asad, Salamullah alayha, and Imam Ali, Salamullah alayha, they remain in Al-Kaaba. Nobody entered into Kaaba, nobody brought the food, nobody brought the water, nobody brought the clothes, nothing. All arrangements were by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fourth point, Imam Ali alayhi salam was given to Prophet Muhammad, and brought up of Imam Ali was under the training of Prophet in childhood. Fifth point, and then we will enter into lifestyle. This is just a family background and some important issues of his birth. Fifth point is, due to the social boycott of Ahle Medina, Imam Ali's father was caretaker of, supervisor of Prophet Muhammad. He was patron of Prophet. And yeah. Yes. A very good point. Nobody asked custodian or somebody else to clean inside of Al-Kaaba, because they knew it. The Allah who opened the door, he must have taken care of everything. So that is why this is one of the fadilat of Imam Ali alayhi salam. Even disbelievers, they did not assume even there was any dirt. Yes, alhamdulillah, this is one of the upgrades of Imam Ali. Even non-believers, disbelievers, they don't believe in Allah, they don't believe in Imamah, they don't believe in prophecy. Even Islam was not announced, it was yet to be announced. Imam Ali was 10 years old when Prophet said, "Qulu la ilaha illallah tuflihu." After 10 years, Islam is going to be introduced. But even 10 years before announcement of Islam, people knew this family is a special family and holy family. Their birth is not like our birth. Nobody has clean. Nobody has asked someone to clean. So with this, there was one of the Mufti Azam of Pakistan. He came to my house in early 90s and he asked me, "What is the difference between your Mawla and my Mawla?" And I told him, where your Mawla was born, worship was haram there. Where my Mawla was born, worship is wajib there. It's the difference of haram and wajib. Now let us enter into the lifestyle of Imam Ali alayhi salam. Imam Ali alayhi salam was very simple personality. He used to wear simple dress. When he was walking on the street, he used to take small steps, not jumping and jogging before the people with the dignity. Imam Ali never interrupted into the conversation. Even his slaves, if they were talking, Imam Ali was keeping quiet and was giving right to others. Imam Ali was one of the big support to Prophet even in his childhood. When the children of Quraysh used to stop the way of Prophet, Imam Ali was pushing them back. Imam Ali alayhi salam was offering the prayer, congregational prayer, behind Prophet for 7 years, and nobody else beside him and Bibi Khadija were congregants of that congregational prayer, because nobody was Muslim. Only two Muslims were there who were following the congregational prayer. Imam Ali, when he was born, he recited first 10 ayat of Surat Al-Mu'minun. Qad aflahal mu'minun ila akhir ulaika yarisun al-firdaus. And when Imam Ali recited these ayat, Allah said, Ashhadu, I am witnessing that they will get fala beka ya Ali. Fala of mu'minun yuflahun beka ya Ali. This was the comments of Allah. And Prophet said, nobody can get fala without Amirul Mu'mineen. Beka ya Ali means by you. In the dua, beka ya Allahu, beka ya Allahu, beka vasila, by the vasila of you. Behaq, behaq or beka, same thing. Ki wajah se. By the reason of, by the source of. Okay. No, he was not. Because if he was offering the congregational prayer, if Abu Talib alayhi salam was offering the congregational prayer, he could not stop the attacks of disbelievers. He was security guard. When there is danger and you see Juma prayer is there, the security guards, they don't offer the prayer. They protect others. If they don't protect, they attack. They will be attacked. So that is why Imam Ali was behind Prophet, but Abu Talib alayhi salam was not offering congregational prayer. He was offering individual prayer to protect the Prophet. No. Yes, for Prophet, he used to pray same, but not the other people, because he knew it. He knew before the order of Allah, commandment of Allah for 5-time prayers, he knew it, that these are like that. Bani Hashim, they used to pray, but not the masses. Masses started after Mi'raj. Yes, Prophet knew it. No, not. In Deen-e Hanif was not the same. Yes. But in the initial stages, they used to offer the prayers like Deen-e Hanif. But for few years, he was offering the prayers like the prayer is ordered. So I can say they used to pray either way, both ways, as direction toward Baitul Muqaddas was okay, and direction toward Kaaba was okay. Sometimes they were praying toward Kaaba, sometimes they were praying toward Baitul Muqaddas. Yes. Yes. That I am telling, before turning to Kaaba, they used to offer the prayers both way, either way. It was okay for them to offer the prayers either toward Baitul Muqaddas or toward Al-Kaaba. Both options were there. Yeah, I understand. Let me clarify. Al-Kaaba was Qibla from the time of Adam, alayhi salam. It was turned, it was changed toward Baitul Muqaddas in the time of Dawood, alayhi salam. From time of Dawood to Prophet Muhammad, it was Baitul Muqaddas. From time of Adam to Dawood was toward Al-Kaaba. Al-Kaaba. After, let me tell, yeah. Regardless Baisat, even when Baisat was there, after Baisat, it was not changed. Kaaba was the same. But it was option. They used to offer the prayers both way. They could prayer, they could direct toward Al-Kaaba or toward Al-Quds. Both way were, they have option, they had option. But when 16 months later on after migration, when it was changed, now it is not okay and allowed to direct toward Al-Quds. That was cancelled, mansukh. That is no more. Yes, it was revealed. Kaaba was revealed. Yes. Yeah. Baitul Ma'mur is on fourth sky. Baitul Atiq was on under the first sky. Like the sun and moon. It was shining. When Adam alayhi salam came, he saw a shining thing beside the stars, moon and sun. It was the fourth thing. And he liked it. And he saw tawaf of angels. He asked Jibreel, what is this and who they are? He told him that these are angels and this is Baitul Atiq, not Kaaba. It was not Kaaba yet. It was Baitul Atiq. Kaaba was not named. It was Baitul Atiq. That was Baitul Ma'mur. When it came down, it became Kaaba. So it was revealed as Quran was revealed. Let us go further. Imam Ali alayhi salam offered the prayers behind Prophet, congregational prayers, for 7 years. Alone, beside Bibi Khadija. Nobody else was there. Imam Ali alayhi salam supported Prophet in his first invitation, which is called Da'wat of Zul Ashira. Wa anzir ashiratakal aqrabin. It took 3 days. Prophet used to invite them and they used to run away. And the last day Abu Talib alayhi salam took out his sword and he said, I won't let you go until you listen what my nephew is saying. And that was the support of Imam Ali and his father. They prepared the food. Food was not that enough. But by the blessing of Allah, it was enough for 40 people. It was hardly enough for 2 people, but it was more than enough for 40 people. 40 people were invited in that first invitation and congregation or convention in which Prophet said, قُلُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ تُفْلِحُوا. when they were about to migrate, Imam Ali slept on the bed of Prophet, and Prophet was saved. Prophet went to Medina and he waited for Imam Ali. It took 2 weeks. Imam Ali came and then they entered into Medina. Imam Ali alayhi salam, his seerat is, his lifestyle is, he was best worshipper of Allah after Prophet and best follower of Prophet in the world. In worship, he has one superior than him. In following of Prophet, nobody is superior than him. He was the best follower of Prophet. He supported Prophet in 84 battlefields, including Uhud, Trench, Khandaq, Badr, Khaybar, etc. Prophet called him Gate of City of Knowledge, Gate of City of Wisdom. Prophet called him as Nasiru Rasulullah, helper of, assistant of Rasul. Prophet was depending on him. Prophet always sought help from him. Prophet always felt comfortable when Imam Ali was with him. Imam Ali had good morality, best morality after Prophet Muhammad. Imam Ali was taking care of elders, taking care of children. Imam Ali was bravest person of the time and number one worshipper of the time beside Prophet Muhammad. So Imam Ali alayhi salam had opposite characteristics, best ruler and very polite, best poet, best worshipper. Imam Ali was not that rich with wealth, but inna al-amira man kana ala nafsihi amira. He was amirul mu'mini. He was spending in the way of Allah whatever he had. Surah Dahar was revealed when Imam Ali's family devoted their food, gave their food in charity. The star came on the house of Imam Ali alayhi salam. Sun came back for the original due prayer of Asr of Imam Ali alayhi salam. The Quraysh and Mushrikeen of Makkah were scared of Imam Ali as he was bravest person and he was most loyal person and most sincere person to Prophet. That is why in the field of Ghadir he was announced as Mawla, as successor of Prophet. Man kuntu Mawlahu fahaza Aliyun Mawla. Imam Ali alayhi salam, when he was given government, he never changed. He was simple. Once Imam Hassan alayhi salam says, Baitul Mal came in late night and I saw my father went to the town of poors and he gave all charity to fuqara, to poor people and came back and he is cleaning the place where this money was placed. Dirham and dinar were placed. And I and my younger brother, Hussein, asked father, why you are making that hurry? It would have distributed in the light of day. Why you have distributed in the night? Imam says, who knows that we are alive in the day. Whenever the trust of Allah comes to you, you are supposed to hasten toward distribution and give to those who deserve. So this is one of the lifestyle. One of the followers of Imam says, I went to Imam, it was night, and there was small lamp. Imam alayhi salam asked me, your job is official or private? He said, my job is private. Then he turned off that lamp. He said, because this lamp is official, so it cannot be used for private issue. So this is another footstep which we can follow. How simple he was. He never took revenge from anyone. He was very polite, very humble. And when he was offering the prayers, even if arrow was in his leg and was taken out in the prayer, and his son asked him, we took out the arrow from your leg and you did not feel any pain. He said, when I offer the prayer, I am connected 100% to Allah. I don't care about my body. He was very simple in wearing, very simple in eating, very simple food. He never ate the grain, gandum. Always he ate jaw. He was saying, because Adam alayhi salam ate it and human beings were punished, so I will never eat. Nane jami. And he was saying, La taj'alu buyutakum qubur al-haywan. Don't eat meat too much. This was the saying of Imam Ali. He was not eating that much meat as well. Yeah. Don't make your stomachs graveyard, cemeteries of animals. Yes. Arthritis. Arthritis and knees problem, they come from the too much eating of meat. Yes. Also, a lot of other arteries problems.
So he was trying to kill the enemy.
Yeah, he was, when he was, yes. When he was killing the Amr ibn Abdibut, and he put his saliva on the face of Imam Ali, and he went out. He did not kill that time. He said, I'll kill him later on. Maybe the people will think that he has killed just due to animosity, personal revenge. But Imam Ali showed us the character. Never use your personal revenge. Just do for sake of Allah. Each and every job should be for sake of Allah. No, this was the trench. This was, yes. Yeah. Ditch, yeah. This was the battle of Ditch, yeah. No, nothing else.
No.
Maybe Sheikh did not study or he forgot something. No. It was in the battlefield of ditch or trench, you say. Trench also? Yeah, trench also. Yeah, same. Yeah. Yeah, both are same. No, it was in this Khandak, not other battlefield. Maybe it happened some other, but this was happened in this Khandak, nothing else. I did not see that. No. He never does that. He never did that because he was a man of principle. The people learned principle from Imam Ali, learned justice from Imam Ali. How just he was, how full of principle he was, how humble he was, how patient he was, how tolerant he was, we can learn from Imam Ali alayhi salam. Salam, sister. Hali shuma khub insha. Khasta na bash. Dashma dard na kun.
Even the sister of Amr ibn Abdewud.
Sister of Amr ibn Abdewud praised. She said, the killer of my brother was Sharif person, noble person. Kareem. Yes. Yes. Word Kareem used. Qatala akhi Kareemun. Wa ma qatala akhi Layimun. This is, even the enemy is praising. Once Muawiyah was asked, how worst enemy Muawiyah was. After the martyrdom of Imam Ali, somebody came to defame Imam Ali. And he said, don't defame Ali. If Ali had one full room of gold and one full room of leftover of grain, he would have spent in the way of Allah gold first and leftover of grain later on. How generous he was. Even Muawiyah says, Rahimallahu Abul Hasan, Wallahi Kana, Hashan Bashah. May Allah bless the soul of Imam Ali. How sweet he was. How many ethical values he had. How moral he was. Yes, that was animosity. And this was reality. They were cursing on Imam Ali and they were admitting that Imam Ali is the bravest, honest, noble, most noble person of the time, this, that. They used to believe it. Character of Imam Ali, sayings of Imam Ali, if you review Nahjul Balagha, if you review Kitabu Ali, if you review Diwanu Ali, if you review Ghurarul Hikam, 11,000 sayings of Imam Ali are written in Ghurarul Hikam. 11,000. Even single is not repeated from Nahjul Balagha. All are new and fresh. Poetry of Imam Ali, Razina Qiswat al Jabbar Fina Lana Ilmun Walil Ada Imalu. Final Mala Yafna An Kharibin. Final Ilma Yabka La Yazalu. Ilm will, yes. Yeah, ditch. Ditch and trench, both. They use both. Ditch and trench. Yeah, khandak. Yes. It never happened in other, this way. Maybe something else. But this story is only for, bring my backpack. Okay, do you have any question? Imam Ali's lifestyle is that lengthy topic. If we discuss 365 days, it is not going to be enough. But if you have any question, yes. Any question? Thank you. Imam Ali's lifestyle is applicable for all of us. Believe me, one of the Christian authors who has written thesis for his doctoral degree from Lebanon, George Zardak. He titled his Arabic language thesis as Qutila Aliyun Li Shiddat Adlih. In Urdu, they have translated Nidai Adalat Insani. Yes. Ali was killed due to his justice. He was strict in justice. How strict he was, Muhammad ibn Hunayf, one of his governors, he deceived in Basra. He took some money in bribery. But Imam wrote him, Muhammad, whenever you receive this letter, come to me. He came and he asked him, I heard you have made a castle in your hometown. From where did you get this money? I know you have no money. He said, from people. Imam Ali alayhi salam said, if you were not governor, they would have given you. He said, no. Imam said, this is bribery. He put him in jail for 3 years. See the justice of Imam Ali. When children of Aqil, his older brother, 20 years older than him, Aqil, when Aqil's sons invited their uncle, Imam Ali, in Kufa, and they provided Imam Ali. Imam Ali was not eating delicious dishes, but they tried to provide to please him. He asked them, from where did you get it? They said, because the scholarship you give us, we saved a little bit for a few months, and then we prepared this food. Imam Ali said, okay, from tomorrow, your scholarship will be reduced. So this is Imam Ali. Who can realize what personality Imam Ali had? Imam Ali alayhi salam really was role model. If people were realizing who Imam Ali is and taking benefit of his footsteps, they would never derail. That is why Hazrat Umar says his opponent, he says, Laula Aliyun lahalaka Umar. Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, yes, in the time of Hazrat Umar, when Hazrat Umar was a ruler, a person came and he registered a complaint against Imam Ali. He said to Umar that Imam Ali hit me. Hazrat Umar said, okay, call him. Alaikum salam. When they called him, he asked, oh Ali, did you hit him? He said, yes. Why? He said, innahu kana yanzuru haramul muslimi. I saw he was deceiving and he was watching with bad intent the namus of Muslims, the ladies. That's why I hit him. Then he could not answer. He bowed his neck. And this person who complained, he asked Umar, you are not providing me justice. He said, Ra'aka Ainullah wa Zarabaka Yadullah. Allah's eye saw you and Allah's hand hit you. What can I do? So this is really, if you review, today's class conclusion is, let us become characterful. Let us learn truth from Imam Ali. Let us learn honesty from Imam Ali. Let us learn simplicity from Imam Ali. Let us learn sincerity from Imam Ali. Let us learn devotion from Imam Ali. Let us learn sacrifice from Imam Ali. Let us learn way of worship from Imam Ali. Let us learn way of forgiveness from Imam Ali. Let us learn morality from Imam Ali. Let us learn generosity from Imam Ali. Let us learn all the etiquettes and habits which can make our life successful. Imam Ali alayhi salam is our role model. Any question? If no question, with this, we will dismiss the class because it's 40 minutes. Inshallah, we start now. Yeah.
The question that even Imam Ali was adil in the battlefield. That when he
two pieces. Yeah, whenever. Yes. Once Mirqal, one of the companions of Imam Ali, had his dress. And Imam Ali was wearing dress of Mirqa. Because nobody was coming in front of Imam Ali in the fight. When he killed a lot of people, Muawiyah was asked, Mirqal has killed that many people. He said, no. He is not Mirqal. If all the bodies are 50-50, he is Ali. So Imam Ali was just even in the battlefield, not even in his own life. May Allah give us capability. Do you know how many sons Imam Ali had? I gave you homework last year, but you did not show me. Can you show me the 18 names of sons of Imam Ali? Nobody can. Please, next week we will take off. Next Sunday, no, we will take off next Sunday because Saturday is Jashan of Imam Ali. There will be late night. So, inshallah, next Sunday we'll take off. You just relax. Following Sunday, please come, which will be 23rd. Yes, 23rd. There will be majlis of Imam Musa Kazim alayhi salam. And also, please bring 18 names of sons of Imam Ali alayhi salam. Who will bring 18 names? I'll give him $100. Please bring 18 names of Imam Ali's son. You win $100. Let us give 200, even 200. Yes. Whoever will write, I'll give him 100. Please. In Karbala, nine, including him, nine altogether. Nine sons, half of it. One son was dead in his life. 17 were alive after the martyrdom of Imam Ali. This is the question. this will make it, inshallah, for 23rd. If you did not answer me, you give me $100. Altogether, yes. Yes, everybody give me at least 100 altogether. So this is a good question, please. Our Imam Ali is our role model, our first Imam, leader of commandments, commander of faithfuls. He is the successor of Imam Ali. He is Saqi Kausar. He is Shafi Mahshar. He is Haider Safdar. He is Ali Murtaza. So we need to know, at least write down 18 names of his sons on refrigerator. Have this. Yes, we are supposed to have this. If you remember, I wrote sometime in Jantri, 18 names. I wrote in Jantri. But alhamdulillah, you will not find that. So inshallah, on 23rd, yes. They were written a few years back. Imam Hassan is, yes, first and second, yeah. And then others, like Abdullah, Jafar, Usman, Aun. Yeah, I told you half. Abul Fazl Abbas, Umar, yes, Umar, yeah. No, Umar Atraf, yes, he is. Yeah. Umar Atraf, yes. Inshallah, next week, we'll discuss next week, yeah, inshallah. So with this, I'll take your permission and we will enter into Dars-e-Quran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.